Hello there. Jeremy Corbyn is reported to be about to table an amendment to the EU Withdrawal Bill that would effectively kill Brexit. According to reports, the Labour leader Jeremy Corbyn will table an amendment to the EU Withdrawal Bill that would make it a government negotiating position to ensure full access to the EU internal market. Guido Fawkes calls it a totally mad and unrealistic objective that could only be achieved with the UK staying in the EU, an analysis with which I totally concur. And junior Brexit Minister Suella Braverman said that this move shattered the Labour Party promise to respect the referendum result. Jeremy Corbyn, John McDonnell, Peter Dowd, Keir Starmer, Barry Gardiner and Nicholas Brown have put the amendment forward, which says, "Internal market negotiating objective. It shall be a negotiating objective of Her Majesty's government to ensure the United Kingdom has full access to the internal market of the European Union, underpinned by shared institutions and regulations with no new impediments to trade and common rights, standards and protections, as a minimum." As this came from the leader of the Labour Party, one assumes its MPs will be whipped to support it. And looking at that paragraph, it sums only one thing up for me. And that is a full remain of the UK in the EU, a total sellout, because to achieve it would require the full EU package and no individual trade deals outside the EU. As the director of the think tank Open Europe, Henry Newman, told City AM, "Labour's amendment is seeking something that's literally impossible. They know perfectly well that they could only achieve full access to the internal market of the EU with no new impediments to trade by keeping free movement, agreeing to allow the EU to shape our taxation and labour law, and signing up to rules which we had no ability to shape. But because it's opposition politics, they can promise unicorns without worrying about having to deliver them." Seems our Jezza is a political opportunist who thinks he can wheedle the keys to number 10 into his hands by saying he will respect the referendum result while pandering to Remainers in a way that would kill Brexit off. But he's not getting it all his own way here, as Labour MPs Chukwuma Mna and Ben Bradshaw, as well as Labour MEP Catherine Stiller, want to see the UK stay in the single market via the European Economic Area, based on one of the Lords' amendments, as they don't think any Tory would vote for the Labour frontbench proposal. All these and the 15 Lords' amendments are going to be debated on and voted on in one day next Tuesday. It could turn into a political bloodbath. Especially as The Telegraph reports that a group of Eurosceptic Tory MPs has sent a 35-page dossier to the PM telling her that any caving into the Lords' amendments would be politically catastrophic and also had the potential to reverse Brexit. The dossier singles out the amendments on giving Parliament a meaningful vote on the final deal, the exit day, a statement on joining the customs union, remaining a member of the European Economic Area, and giving the Irish Republic a say over security in Northern Ireland, said The Telegraph. But while Labour is playing with the EU withdrawal bill, don't forget the Tory Remainers. 12 Tory MPs have put forward their own amendment to another bill going through the process, the trade bill. This amendment would make it an objective to join the European Free Trade Association and stay as a member of the European Economic Area. Sounds like part of a combined pincer movement to me. Anyway, I hear that David Davis, the Brexit Secretary, is not a happy bunny. It seems that number 10 officials are, for the fifth time, rewriting and so delaying again the 150-page Brexit blueprint white paper that sets out our future relationship with the EU. David Davis is described by a friend as very bullish on this, and that Mr. Davis was prepared to challenge the PM's authority and go to the whole cabinet with his concerns over the delays. David Davis wants to get this detailed position out there, but the PM, her office and HMRC apparently want it delayed, and even cabinet ministers aren't allowed to see it yet. You have to ask yourself what is going on. Overall, though, next Tuesday, the 12th of June, will be a pivotal day, and you have to wonder if the rumours of a snap general election in the autumn aren't as outlandish as they might have previously seemed. Finally, a Scottish Government report has admitted that Brexit could generate 5,000 jobs and £540 million for the Scottish fishing industry. Now, there were four models, and the only one that was negative for the UK was if EU fishermen retained their current quotas in the UK exclusive economic zone. With the Telegraph saying, a report commissioned by agency Marine Scotland found that the UK leaving the EU's hated common fisheries policy and gaining the entire quota from its waters would increase the seafood sector's economic output by up to 21%. Although tariffs and other trade barriers from leaving the single market would have a negative impact, these would be far outweighed by the impact of reallocating catch in British waters from foreign to Scottish vessels. Now, before the Remainers say that I always disparage reports when they say nasty things about Brexit, so why am I quoting this one? I have to say that I'm just telling you what the report says, but smiling while I do it. So, what do you think? Please let us all know by leaving a comment below. Thank you for watching. Please do like and share this video, and also subscribe to my channel. And when subscribing, please do remember to press on the little bell next to the subscribe button. That way you'll get an alert every single time I put up a new video. Thank you very much for watching.